Hey guys, Colleen here, DIYer behind lemonthistle.com, and today I am excited to be in my new office filming my first video here. Feels so good. But also to be in 2020 and looking back at the year 2019. So I'm doing a video that I do every year. I've always done it in post format until last year. And I'm just looking back at the best of the best and sharing what projects were super popular with you guys and sharing what projects I thought should be more popular because I loved them. So I have my top 10 YouTube videos that I'm gonna be sharing from the year that were published in 2019. And then I'm also gonna be sharing my top 5 blog posts from the year, my top 5 blog posts from any time that were popular over the year, and my top 5 underdogs, which are the ones that I really loved that I want you guys to see, even though they didn't pick up the traction that the other ones did. Thank you for being here. This year has been so cool on so many levels. I mean, I went from like 3,000 YouTube subscribers to, I think I'm at 17,000 YouTube subscribers, which for me is incredible. I love getting to share videos with you guys every week, and I'm hoping to be back with a new video every Saturday, but I do have 4 young children, so don't hold me to it. But it's just been such a fun year of growth and learning something new. Video is something that does not come naturally to me. This was a bit of a challenge, especially the editing portion. Send all the tips and videos my way on how to do that. But I just so appreciate you guys. Thank you again for being here. Let's check out what you liked the most. If you have not yet subscribed to my channel, I would so love if you did that below so you don't miss out on any more DIY or home decor videos. I'm talking very fast. It's my second coffee. All right, so starting with number 10 most popular on YouTube is this DIY doormat here. This is a really simple DIY I'd actually made a couple times before, and I made this video after finding the best way to do it. It holds up super well, you don't need stencils. I love this method. Number 9 is how to install pot lights in your house. Super exciting. Number 8 is the dollar store DIY challenge that I did with my friend Christine, and that is something that I definitely want to bring back this year and do more dollar store DIYs because they're just so fun. Number 7, and I'm so happy this made the list, is my faux wood shades. These I've used in so many rooms in my house. They are such an affordable way to get that style, and yeah, I just really love them, and I was disappointed that they didn't make my top blog post for the year. Number 6 is how to style open shelving in your kitchen. This is a really fun how-to video, and after watching it back to get the clip for this, I kind of want to change up my shelves again. Number 5 is my boys' bedroom makeover. This I did for the One Room Challenge, which is a 6-week room makeover challenge. I am so happy with how this turned out. I love the challenge of designing a room with my kids and the things that they love and still making it a style that I am proud to have in my house. Number 4 is a Cricut for Silhouette video where we're talking about transfer tape. Again, super exciting. But these Cricut for Silhouette videos will be back. They have been popular and I've had lots of questions, so we're excited to address some new topics. Number 3 is our garage makeover. This was done in January of last year, so just about 1 year ago, and this was such a big undertaking, but it is a space that we are so happy to have, and it definitely doesn't look this clean at the moment. In the number 2 spot is my DIY molding wall in my master bedroom. I totally love this project. I am excited that it made the list, especially so high. I am just busy thinking of where else we can put molding walls in our house because they're so good. Number 1, the most popular, is 4 basic macrame knots to make pretty much any macrame tutorial that you find out there. I definitely want to get some more macrame tutorials on YouTube this year. I have one that I'm going to be sharing in my master bedroom shortly that I'm working on making a tutorial for as well. So that is my top 10 YouTube videos for the year that were published to YouTube in 2019. All right, now let's get to blog posts. These are my top 5 blog posts that were published in 2019 on the blog. Number 5 is the DIY plywood double desk that we made for our boys' bedroom makeover. This is an IKEA hack using maple plywood and a waterfall edge and then vertical shiplap underneath the desk, but it's actually super simple to make. Number 4 is a Roundup, which I feel like is super lame to include in this list, but it was popular and it was 40 modern DIYs for the home. There is a bunch of mine in there, and some of these projects are so good. So if you love modern DIY, definitely check that one out. Number 3 is all about Cricut Snap Mat. This was another Cricut vs Silhouette YouTube video that I put into a blog post, and I guess people on the blog want to know about Snap Mat. Number 2 are my 5 calendars for 2020. These are free printables that I do every year. They are one of my very favorite things to do every year. And then in the number 1 spot, wouldn't you know it, matching the YouTube number 1 is the 4 basic macrame knots. All right, next up is top 5 posts in 2019 that were published during any time. In the 5th place is 3 DIY giant yard games. This is an old post, but people still love it. And the most popular game in here is, of course, the giant Jenga. Number 4 is how to cut out your own image with Cricut, which again is another Cricut vs Silhouette video over on YouTube. This is one we did last year, and this is one of my most popular YouTube videos of all time as well. It is also my YouTube video with the most negative comments. So, win some, lose some, I guess. In number 3 place is how to make yearly photo books that are beautiful, modern, and don't make you want to cry while you're making them, because organizing hundreds and hundreds and thousands of photos can be super stressful. But I share my strategy on organizing photos, editing them, and getting them into photo books in this post. Number 2 spot is my split level entry makeover. This was a before and after renovation that we did in our last house. This is a cathedral entry home where we added drawers for shoe storage and replaced like everything top to bottom in this entryway. In the number 1 spot, yep, this guy made number 1, how to disassemble a pallet. This is the last one of my super old blog posts that is still hanging on and pulling in traffic. Even though I kind of wish it wouldn't, which feels like a really great time to move on to my underdog posts. These are 5 posts that I genuinely love that didn't see as much traffic during the year, but I feel like deserve the shout out as well. So in number 5 place is this how to embroider on wood craft that I did. This was super fun to stretch myself creatively, and I love the effect of the embroidery on wood. Number 4 is this autumn greens tablescape. I love a good tablescape, and they never do as well traffic wise, but they're one of my favorite things to pull together, so I just had to include one, and this was probably my favorite from the year. Number 3 is our entryway makeover. This was a super big project for us. It was a little bit of a stressful project for us when our railing started falling apart while we were replacing our flooring. So it feels so good to have it done, and it looks better than I ever thought that that space could. Number 2 is this DIY concrete wall cover. We covered an old concrete retaining wall in our backyard with this modern black wood slats, and I really love how it modernizes our patio space, and it was a fairly simple DIY to pull together. And then number 1, you know I could not ignore this, office. We made over our basement into a studio office for myself, and I am just feeling so lucky to get to call this space mine and to get to work in here. So the reveal video went up right before Christmas, and it includes both the studio side and the office side, and it is where I'm sitting right now. It's so funny to me, what is popular over on the blog is not necessarily what's popular over on YouTube, which is definitely not what's popular over on Instagram. Instagram just likes like the big room shots, and they like to see my laundry pile, actually. So I don't know guys, but what I do know is that I've got a bunch of really fun things planned this year. I was just talking to Alexis from Purgaloo, and our Cricut vs Silhouette series is going to be back. We're going to be doing a video for that hopefully this month. We're going to be looking at using the draw tool on Silhouette and Cricut. But if you have any suggestions for that series, I'd love to hear them in the comments below. I am also planning more home tours. I'm planning more DIYs. I've got a macrame tutorial in the works because that seemed to be YouTube likes macrame. I don't know. So there's so much in the works, guys. I'm really excited. I hope that you subscribe and stick around and see what I'm up to this year. And again, if you have any suggestions for videos, I'd love to take those into consideration. So pop them in the comments below. We'll see you guys next time.